Hi everyone, we're back again from the NCVE with another fun activity. This time we're going to be doing tasty treats, making edible DNA. And here's a model of some DNA which we're going to be replicating using some of your favourite sweets and some cocktail sticks. So for this video you need some cocktail sticks, these are going to act as our bonds. You need some long sweets, so long thick sweets. I went for strawberry pencils, and these are going to act as our two strands of DNA to be twisted together to make our helix. And you need some sweets that come in varieties of four colours or four different types. So for example, something like, I went for jelly beans as we've got four different colours in there. You could use fruit pastels, jelly babies, dolly mixtures. Just make sure it's something that you can easily thread with a toothpick, so not something like a Smartie, because that's going to be very difficult. So before we get on with the sweets, we're just going to go through DNA quickly. So DNA is short for deoxyribonucleic acid. And DNA has all the instructions that a living organism, so like me and you, need to grow, to function, and to reproduce. And if you want to think about it in a different way, it's like our recipe. Just like if you were to bake a cake, you follow a recipe, which is an instruction. Each person has a different recipe, and that's why different people look different. So take a look at the people around you, your parents or your siblings or your friends. There are visible differences between you, and those visible differences are due to DNA. So I want you to pause the video now and have a think about those people around you, so think about your friends and your family, and write down some of the visible differences that you can see between yourselves. So just like different cakes are baked from different recipes, each person has a different pattern of DNA or a different recipe. So I don't know what you mentioned, but perhaps you mentioned eye colour or hair colour. Perhaps you mentioned height or skin colour. And all these differences are due to DNA. We are each made up, as I said, of a different recipe, which defines how we naturally look. And as we said, that recipe is the instruction known as DNA. DNA is made up of two strands, and we can see the purple and the red. This is our helix, and you can see that we've got two strands twisted around. And for our edible DNA, we're going to be using our strawberry pencils or other thick, long sweets as our strands. And these strands are made up of sugars and other chemicals like phosphates. DNA is found in all cells of living organisms. You and I are made up of cells. Cells contain the DNA in a very specific part, in a compartment, and that compartment is called the nucleus, which you can see on the screen. DNA is a large chemical recipe made up of small chemical components called bases. There are ingredients, if you like. And there are four bases which go by letters. So we have A for adenine, T for thymine, C for cytosine, and G for guanine. So we don't really need to worry about the long names. If you like, you can just remember them by the letters. So the order of these letters on the DNA helix is what makes up our recipe. And everyone has the bases in different patterns, which provides us with a different recipe or a different genetic code. So the order of these letters, the order of the bases on the DNA helix, is what makes our recipe. Everyone has these bases in different patterns, which provides us all with a different recipe. And as you can see on the model here, we have a variation in colour, so if I twist it round, we have green and yellow, orange and blue, green and yellow, orange and blue, green and yellow. And if we take the green as being base A, the yellow as base T, the orange as base C, and the blue as base G, you will see that as you go through the model, we've always got green and yellow bonding together, so A and T, and we've always got C and G bonding together, so orange and blue. And that's a very important rule in the DNA helix, which we need to follow when we make up our edible DNA. So what we're going to do is now make our edible DNA. So DNA is double-stranded, as we saw. So to make our double strands, this is what we're going to do. So we've got our two strands here, and if you want to make them longer, you could attach another strawberry pencil to it with a cocktail stick. So you could do that if you want to make a long helix. You've got your bases, as in our jelly beans, and you've got your cocktail sticks as your bonds. So what we're going to do is take our jelly beans. We need to first of all work out which colours are going to be which bases. So I'm going to take yellow to be A and red to be T. I'm going to take orange to be C and green to be G. It's a little bit easier if you take your jelly beans, put them on a plate and put them in the microwave for less than 10 seconds, and I mean less than 10 seconds, because I'm not taking any responsibility if you blow up your microwave by exploding your sugar. So less than 10 seconds, just so you can make your jelly beans a little bit softer. And then when you've done that, you can take your cocktail sticks and start threading your base pairs on. So you want to have two base pairs per cocktail sticks, and remember to stick with your A and T and C and G bonding. So now we have all of our different bases attached to our first strand of DNA. We can then start attaching them to the second one, a little bit like this. So here we have what we call our DNA ladder, and if we twist it at the top and the bottom, ta-da, we have our DNA helix. So I hope you've enjoyed the video today. And please do let us know what your DNA helixes look like, so you can tweet them, Instagram them, or email them to us. So please do subscribe to our channel to get notifications when we next upload videos, and we'll see you for the next one. Bye.